And welcome back to Polly's Ego Trip. Today we're going to cook something. Always inspired by music myself, been listening to a bit of Bob Vylan. And Bob Vylan said this. Now season, darling, veg, fresh herbs. Cut caffeine because it messed with nerves. Plenty lentils and chickpea curry. 20 minute meal for a man in a hurry, that's real fun. Let's make a chickpea curry. What do you reckon? It's dead easy. Dead easy. I've got a camera here that I can talk into and maybe hold stuff up for. I've got this little one, which I'm going to do all this kind of there's. Our little help Sass, he's going to give us a, he'll help us about a bit. And that can go there. So what you're going to need for your chickpea curry, that's a tin of chickpeas. They're about 39 pence an Aldi, I think. So you're going to need them. I'm going to put some mushrooms and I'm going to put some frozen spinach in there. But what you need to do first is make your paste. Now you can buy paste out at the shops, but it's fairly expensive. And sometimes it's a bit tasting. The tack ones are all right. But what we'll do here is we'll show you how to make your own paste using a teaspoon. All these lovely things here. So what we're gonna get is, we're gonna stick a teaspoon of peppercorns in there. Then we're gonna stick a teaspoon of turmeric in there. That's more about color than anything else. Teaspoon of gran masala, chili powder, bit of that in there. Oh, thank you. Get a bit of cumin in there. That's going to give it flavour, along with a wee bit of coriander. Put that in there too. Then garlic. Now I'm going to try some here. This is an organic. This is the garlic peel thing. That's my friend got me, and it's shit. Lovely thought, not very good. What you can do, I'm told, is you can use an item like this, drop it in there, and then just give it a shake, we're having a cocktail. And when you pour it out, look at all the garlic. Thanks for that, Sass. Look at all the garlic. Right, so I'd say 4 or 5 cloves in there. Get them in there. Now, it doesn't really matter how you chop this, because you're just going to drop it in here. That's probably best to give it a couple of slices here and there. You're just going to play with that all the way through this now, are you? I was going to do this years ago, and then the old dirty vegan popped up. And he kind of did it already, so like I say in my intro on the page, I'm going to kind of do all sorts of stuff in this, I think. Later in the year, I might do a little trip around the country, meeting people that I know, doing a bit of music. Right, next, thumb of ginger, actual ginger. You can use crushed ginger if you like, but I just think this is a bit more chompable. Stick that in there. That's your ginger and your garlic. I'll put the actual recipe in the comments. Bit of salt, and just to give it a bit of a kick, I'm going to use some hot powder. Right, let's get a pump on. Let's get this one in there. Look at that. Ooh. In there, get some away. Now, I probably made a little bit too much here, because I always do. But you can freeze it and use it again. Make sure everything is mashed up. Mash it up. Give it a good squeeze. I feel like a proper cook if you use it. Mortar and pestle. Oh, loads of that there, look. You get a bowl for that because, oh, whew. And your spoon. I've made way too much, so you might want to just take some of them numbers down a bit. Do not go easy on the garlic. Not one for me mate, Andy Whitehill. Someone's got a migraine because I had round mushrooms. That's a very real thing. So we'll put that to one side. Now we want the ingredients. Good knife. Shrooms. Always in a plastic bag. Not in a plastic bag. Put that there, I don't know how this is going to work with that. Right. That was a bit fucking manky. Give it a rough chop. All good, get your fingers out of the way. Keep your fingers out of the way. Get them all squished up and nice and black. Okay. And an onion. Get that sliced up nice. And once we've got that, we'll get some frozen spinach out. Now, you can use proper, real fresh spinach, but we all know you buy a bag about this size, and once you've got it down to that, it's about 850 quid. Frozen spinach costs pence, and it doesn't vanish when you get it down. So, get a 4 or 5 of them little beauts in there. That is your chickpea curry. I'm also going to chuck a bit of the old passata in mine because chef's kiss. Probably don't need to say chef's kiss when you're doing your chef's kiss, but whatever. Right, let's go over here and cook this shit up. Okay, so what you're going to need is a nice big pan. Ram it on nice and hot. Put this up here for now. Right, so yeah, big pan. All the ingredients over here. Remember, you've made far too much of this paste. You can stick a bit of tomato puree in that as well, just to kind of gooble it up a bit. But anyway, we're going to use half of that. So you've already got this made, so this is how quickly and easy this is to do. So, pan's warming up nice. Give it a good glug of olive oil, because you're a grind boy, or lady, or non-binary person. And the heat coming off that. Nice. So I turn the heat down now and put in your shrooms and your onion. I'm gonna put some shroom and onions in my tea. Put that in there. Stir it up, get it all nice and covered in grease. Okay, and while all that's getting nice and reduced, and the onions are browning up a bit. Don't give them too much though. Oh. Want a bit of crack in there and it's going to be cooking for a while. So, next thing you do, throw in the old frozen spinach. So, we can see here that there is frozen spinach in there. And then we're gonna drop some of that in. The next thing we're gonna do, just get yourself a couple of good tablespoons full of that lovely paste. Drop a little bit more olive oil on it for mine, and then dry that off. You'll start to smell the goodness. Now, a couple of minutes ago, while I was messing about with the cameras and that, I decided to make myself some vegetable stock. Easy enough, a litre of water, boiling water, vegetable stock cube. Get them nice and cheap, get them fancy ones. Fancy they are. Right. So give that a good stir, that's ready to rock and roll. Then we're going to stick in our chickpeas with the water or aquafaba, or you vegans out there, you can use that as an egg replacement should you wish to do so. Don't use it in baking, it's crap. Makes everything too watery. Right, wipe that up a bit, stick a bit more of that in. To me, to you. Then I just give it a squirt of the old passata just to give it some more grooviness. And then pour in about enough water to cover the chickpeas. Them chickpeas are gonna shuck all that loveliness in. Be dead tasty in that. Oh, escapee, get back in there, you booger. Right, a bit more stock. That, my friends, is ready to simmer. So, let's bring that down here. Whack it up a bit. Give it a scrumble like that. Give it a taste, actually, see what you think. Oh god, yeah. Oh my goodness. Right. We'll do a ding 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 time thing. We'll just leave that, we'll bring it to the boil. When it's boiling, or just starting to boil, you're just going to turn it down ever so slightly to about a medium heat so that it just keeps that up. And what you try to do is try to get rid of some of that water in there, unless you want to make yourself a broth and then just stick more water in it. Could be like a spicy broth as well, that's nice. But yeah, I'm going to let this, as you can see there, and it's just starting to give itself a bit of grief around the edges. Let's leave that to do its thing. Alright. Right then, turn this off, that's about 15 minutes, whatever. Man, this is good. Look at that. A little taste. Possibly a little bit more salt. Yeah, come with me to the land where the salt is. Bit of a pinch of that. Give it a bit of a stir. And then, let's see what we can do about plating it up. There we go. Look at that, eh? Oh. It's gonna be delish. This is gonna be delish. Gonna be delish. Right, I'm gonna go to my proper camera now. So there we have it. Chickpea curry, 20 minutes. This is a meal for a man in a hurry. Chickpeas, spinach, mushrooms, onion. All those spices, bit of tomato, good for you. Well, I can't eat all these because I might do a down next for you lot. So join me next time, hit the like button, subscribe, see if we can get this something going with this or whatever, which this video look really dated now in about 10 years time if I don't, well I either do or don't get successful at this. Some music's next, alright, maybe, okay, take care, see you next time.